Okay, we've already touched on some of the image review capabilities while you're in 2D. We went up to this screen over here. We hit the pointer, came up, and you can left double click to get that back up on the screen. You can select another and get them side by side. Keep selecting them, or deselect them. And we'll go back, deselect them all, and then you can get to your image review right there. I'm going to go back to 2D and show you how to get to that in a different way. But one other thing that wasn't covered is you can right-click on it, and it'll give you an X. So it'll show those images on there, and it won't delete them until after you end the patient. So if you can't accidentally delete an image while you're scanning. Now, the same thing can be done. At the end of an exam, you can go to review the images by pressing this little icon here. It's right below this third button. It looks like four little sector images on a scan screen. And now you can review the images here by double-clicking on them, going to the full screen, and you'll go right back to what you saw before, where you can select multiple images to compare them. Now note, if you want to see another image without seeing them side by side, double-click quickly, and it'll pull it back up. You can also click this page to flip through, and it'll reselect various images. I don't know if you can see the yellow highlight flipping by on all these, but that's what the page button does. And you can select, and even after the image is done, let me go back and deselect this, you can go to the next page and click compare, and you can see a live image versus what's on there right now. I have the sector probe, so it's actually showing a sector image here. But even after the scanning is done, you can go back to the archive and still compare these two images. So I'm going to go back to that archive screen. Let's say I don't want to see the current patient. You want to see a previous patient. Come up here and search for study. And see, I've got this just as study date for today. So it's only showing this right here. If I want to select a separate one, I can go to the last 7 days and pull up a previous. I'm going to choose that, click search. I can also search by MRN number, last name of the patient, and various types of things such as the study types. Again, when you want to start a new patient, or I'm sorry, start a new exam with a previous patient, this is where you would come to get that MRN number, which is right here. So I'm going to pull up this current one because it makes it much easier. So I can open it up, delete, export, DICOM, print. Since it's already open, it's not going to let me do anything. I can just hit close, and it's the active patient, so it's not going to let me select that. So here I can do the same. I can right-click on these and get a whole lot more options. I can go ahead and delete the image, undelete the image. I can export that image, and we'll get to exporting later. I can add a caption, flag it, or add it to the report. So let's go ahead and add that image in the report, and I can add a caption there. I'll just, you know, put that on there. Put another image on there. I can also make my thumbnails look different. I can go to 5 wide to make them smaller. Go to 3 wide, make them a little bigger so I can see them better. So I'll go ahead and just delete this image, and I'll add this one to the report. And you can also add images to the report. I can click on it here, and up here it'll say add image to report, and I've already added it, so it won't work again. I can end the exam from here if I want to move on to the next exam, import studies from another system, or export the selected images. And we'll get to image export later, but just real quick, if you wanted to export it, you can click on that, and you can choose if there's a USB attached, you can put it in there, or if you have a PAC system or DICOM set up, you can export it to that as well. We'll get to that more later, but this is just another place where you can export that patient information. So let's take a quick look at the report. That's this little page here between the third and fourth buttons. It's like a little tear at the bottom. Builds up your report, and now those two images that I added are there, the results of the two Doppler measurements I made in the vascular portion. You can change your templates if you create your own. You can edit the template. And here, you can also export that report to DICOM. Here, you're going to say send report data, And that's where you're going to go ahead. And that's not set up right now. I don't have my system connected to a network, so it's not going to be able to transfer. But that's what you would click on to send the structured report over. But as we'll see later when I get to the export video, you'll see that you can export that structured report along with the images, so you don't have to do it twice. But if you want to be sure, you can go ahead and click that anyway. Here you can look for a new patient folder, also end exam, same things as you could be as you could do before. So anyway, we'll click report again to get out of that. And next we'll get into the system setup and customizing your system.